SAS Quality Indicators software was originally developed by the Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality in the late 1990s. Version 6.0 was released in June 2016. There are three important software announcements. First, the ICD-10 SAS QI version 6.0 will not include risk adjustments because one full year of ICD-10 data is required in order to develop complete risk adjustment models. Second, the ICD-10 SAS QI version 6.0 package will include all four modules in a single release in 2016. And finally, the ICD-9 SAS QI software version 6.0 will be released by module incrementally throughout 2016. This tutorial will walk you through how to compute ARC quality indicators using SAS QI version 6.0. Throughout the presentation, we will be referring to a few resource documents that are available for you to download from the ARC QI website. The SAS packages are organized as four modules: Providing Inpatient Quality Indicators, or IQIs; Pediatric Quality Indicators, or PDIs; Prevention Quality Indicators, or PQIs; and Patient Safety Indicators, or PSIs. You can use the programs in these modules to produce observed and expected quality indicator rates, risk-adjusted quality indicator rates, MSX smooth rates, and other condition-specific rates. Now, let's talk about the hospital discharge dataset that you will bring into SAS. The input data file has to be a SAS dataset with required elements in specified formats. You may have to recode data elements to match what's expected by the SAS program. For instance, the variable name for gender has to be sex, coded 1 for male and 2 for female. You can find more details in section 5.1 of the manual, Software Input Data. You will also need to check the data dictionary in Appendix C. Table 27 specifies the format for each variable that will be used in each module. In addition, diagnoses and procedures must be coded in compliance with the ICD-9 CM codes. There are also specific requirements for coding MS-DRGs and MDC. If there are no APR-DRG categories in your input data, you should run the APR-DRG grouper program first. This will create DRGs for you. It is required that users either use their own grouper software or download and run APR-DRG grouper on their patient discharge data before running the IQI module. Finally, don't forget to code all types of missing values as a single value: a period for numeric variables, and a blank space for character variables. Now we're ready to get started. We'll use the IQI module for our demonstration. Remember, we have extracted 12 SAS programs, 2 ASCII text files, and 24 CSV files. We can use these files to compute 28 provider-level indicators and 4 area-level indicators, plus 2 composite indicators. You can find technical specifications for these indicators on our website by selecting IQI Resources under the Module menu. Then, scroll down to the link for technical specification, which takes you to the individual QI technical specification. Let's bring in the input data by copying and pasting it in the folder where you have downloaded the SAS QI software. Hospital discharge input data should be formatted as SAS dataset. As I mentioned earlier, please go through the documentation for more instructions on formatting. For example, IQI_sample is the input dataset in SAS format that contains hospital discharge data, and POP95T15 is the area-level population data text file. The population file can be downloaded from the ARC website. Let's take a look at the hospital discharge input dataset in SAS format. This is how the data will look in SAS. Create 2 new folders, SAS Data and Formats, inside IQI Directory. The first SAS program you need to run is iqi_control.sas. Double-click to open it. After you open the program, you'll find brief instructions about the module. Further down, you'll reach the most important section, a checklist that will guide you through the entire process. Please read these instructions carefully. To simplify, let's modify only the required part of the program. Replace path name with the full string of the directory path where you downloaded the SAS software. We have 18 places where you need to replace the path name. In addition, you will need to change the input. DIS folder specifies the folder that contains the discharge dataset. Copy and paste the path of your SAS discharge input dataset. Discharge specifies the name of the discharge data file. Replace it with your SAS discharge input dataset name. POP file specifies the file path of your population file. Copy and paste the full folder path. You can ignore any further changes even though they are described as user must modify. In addition, you will need to change the population year based on your data. You are basically setting up the location of the input and output files for all other SAS programs. You can ignore any further changes even though they are described as user must modify. Let's talk about the optional edits that are described as user may modify. For example, here this code means that IQP2 is the output dataset generated when we run program P2, that is iqsas p2.sas. This IQP2 dataset becomes the input for program P3, that is iqsas p3.sas. IQP3 is the output dataset produced when we run program P3. Users have the option of changing these dataset names. After you have made all the necessary modifications to the control program, save and click Run. Make sure to check that the log file does not contain any errors. Errors appear in gray color, otherwise the logs are in blue. Now, you must run the second SAS program, iqi_formats.sas. Double-click to open it. For the rest of the SAS programs after the control program, you must edit the programs to specify where the control program is located. This is the only editing these programs need. Replace path name with the directory path of your downloaded SAS software location, the same as we did in the control program. Save it and click Run. These first two programs set up the SAS environment for the remaining programs by creating necessary SAS libraries that are used by other SAS programs. Next, we are going to run iqi_measures.sas. This program assigns inpatient quality indicators to each inpatient record. You'll need to tell SAS where the control program is located, as we just did in the format program. Replace path name with your directory path. This is the only editing needed in this program. Save it and click Run. The program displays output. Now you can take a look at your output dataset produced by the program. The program produces output dataset in the folder SAS data. In the output dataset IQ1, the calculated numerator and denominator for all IQI indicators will be stored. Output dataset IQ1 becomes the input for the next program. Now you are ready to compute either provider level or area level inpatient quality indicators. To obtain the 28 provider level indicators, you should run program iqi_provider_1.sas, which will give you the observed rates. Give the full path of the control program location. This is the only editing needed. Save the program and click Run. Program displays screen output. You can see the output dataset IQP2 created in our directory. Let's open it and take a look at the data. In this case, we have used 16 hospitals in our dataset. For example, the output is showing indicator IQI01 numerator values. All other provider-level reporting data for all indicators will be contained in its own column in the output file. Similarly, if you want to calculate the observed rate for the area-level indicators, you should run IQI_area_1.sas instead of IQI_provider_1.sas right after the format program, as shown previously. These steps are the same, except you will see the output datasets IQA2. Now that we have seen how to run the programs, let's see how to extract the data in SAS dataset to a spreadsheet. For example, let's choose IQP3. Note that the column heading can be displayed as column labels or column. Note that the column heading can be displayed as column labels or column names by going to the View menu and select Column Labels or Column Names. To export the data, go to the File menu and choose Export Data. Make sure you select the checkbox that displays Write Variable Labels as Column Names. Click Next. Select Microsoft Excel Workbook.xls from the list and click Next. Give the path on your computer where you want to export the data. Type a name for your file and click Save. Type a name for your file and click Save. Click Next and make sure to click Finish. You can see the data extracted into a spreadsheet. Let's summarize the output sets that are of interest. Provider-level quality measures can be found in output dataset IQP2. IQP2 gives observed rates. Similarly, area-level quality measures can be found in output datasets IQA2. You can download the SAS QI full software package, which includes all four modules, from the ARC website, or you can download each module separately. The ARC website provides many additional resources to help users analyze their own data. You can also download the SAS QI version 6.0 manual, which covers all the topics we talked about today in greater detail. If you encounter any technical difficulties, you can visit our FAQ and support page, or send an email to qisupport@arc.hhs.gov. The ARC Quality Indicators support team can also be reached by phone in the USA at 301-427-1949. Messages are responded to within 3 business days.